following clip was part of my livestream on the 22nd of December. If you want to see the entire livestream back on YouTube, you can. The link is in the description. What was that? Oh, hello. You're in the voice chat. How are you doing? That's a bit of a short answer. Okay, then you're probably exhausted. Okay. You were a taxi driver, right? Okay. Okay, yeah. The mute button is something I use often. Or the snooze button, rather. So, how long haven't you been playing Digimon Heroes? Okay, but when did you stop? Oh yeah, okay, so as soon as the announcement came. Oh, Soviet says he can't hear you in the stream, that's weird. Oh yeah.
They can't?
Should be able to hear me now.
Well, do we do the interview again?
I can actually hear myself through your microphone as well, which is not great.
What?
I accidentally muted the asshole.
You muted me.
Yeah.
Well, that's rude.
Sorry, man. Sorry.
It's okay. I'm just joking.
You muted me. Yeah, I can hear the stream back through your mic. So, if you
I just turned it off.
Okay. Sure. Cool.
I was having it on my tablet.
Oh yeah. Sure. So, what do you think about the agumon? Agumon things.
The new mons?
Yeah, the agumon quest.
Well, I was maybe planning to play the quests, but I have not found any time for. There has not been any day offs.
Oh right, yeah. I personally like that they released it.
Yeah.
Because it would have been a shame if they just left it.
They were really unsipitated.
Mm.
Like they only came every so often, half a year, for one.
Yeah, it took a couple months for a new one to arrive, and now they're doing. I think the last couple of days have been 3 or 4, which is cool.
Yeah, I've been logging in the game just to get the free X if I some way find motivation to. Do last pulls and try to complete as much of the collection as possible.
Oh right, yeah. I saw they had a leaderboard now where you can see how many.
Yeah, I used to be at somewhere top 100, but now I'm like 1,200.
Sure. Yeah, and I don't know, the old events come back. Of course, some people are gonna try to collect them all.
Yeah, like I was saving every ticket. Like for so damn long, waiting for 5+2 and the HD sales to get more space.
Yeah, that's what I used to do too when I played. I'm still playing the game, of course, now. Right.
Yeah,
now.
I see.
So I'm really trying to get those agumon items.
Yeah, for. Like, I still remember before I heard the news, there was the triple event, the Halloween and the Damn Hisuari and the Giga Seedramon. I finished the Giga Seedramon, then made a small mistake with the Hisuari and was planning to send a support ticket, but just then when I came home, I saw the news and I was like, damn.
Yeah.
I was so damn heartbroken.
I'm right now looking at the collection leaderboard and I'm ranked 6,447 with 601 Digimon unlocked. So, Number one is of course Strikey with 1,040 Digimon. And DGK is actually number three with 1,029. Shared number two even. So that's cool. And Citrus is number seven. What is he doing?
Well, it's not really, when you think about it, if you collected all the daily bonuses, then it should be, and you've been collecting free tickets, then it should be pretty easy to get some of those drops.
Yeah, I guess so. That's true.
Like, I didn't pull a single of them when they released a bunch of the new rotations. I have, like, plus 1,000 of each ticket.
Yeah, okay. Oh, that's a lot. I really don't know
how much.
I only have a couple. Speaking of them, I'm probably going to do a couple ticket pulls. After I'm done with the agumon thing. But now that the, what's his name, Jupitermon is out, I kind of want to make him. I kind of want to finish him.
Like, I had the ideas for so long, like, what part of the game is really competitive, the tower and the weekly arena, what's it?
PvP.
Yeah, PvP. Like, PvP was just a chore, and then for tower, if you had some of the more premium effective mons and some time, you could in just, well, it took 5 to 7 hours to climb to the higher ranks. Then it just came like really tediously.
Yeah, exactly.
But like the, how it's said, like without using continuous, it used to be, was it somewhere 14 to 15. To tiers that you could go without dying, and then when the I forgot the name. Alphamon, or you can VS Deathexmon. Like that, those skills are so broken for the tower.
Okay.
Like that is single-handed the best towermon that has ever existed.
Okay.
And that was. Like, when those free DM pulls were introduced for daily, I got really pissed for, like, when you miss some, the older legendary, it's like, it felt then that you missed the chance for a really long time, for who knows, a year or so. That was when I started to use some money on the game.
Oh, okay.
And when the Alphamon was introduced, I like tripled the money usage on the to double the pool.
Okay.
For both the Ulfors and the Alpha.
Okay.
Because it just felt like if you didn't have that playing tower against others for the race competition, it would have been just a drag.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, right now they are. The number one in the tower was like tier 166.
Yes.
I mean, what the fuck is that about? That's, we used to be able to get to like, I mean, the number one used to get to like tier, I don't know, 30 or something. And now they're like 166. That's insane.
Well, the luck Renator used to get to the went really hardcore and went all the way to that tier 300.
Really? Jesus.
Yes.
300. Wow. So,
like before that, the record, like DGK had the record for every so long, and then it was it Verdatus who broke it.
Okay. Yeah, the tower. I was never really a fan of the tower. The idea of the tower was really good, but the implementation wasn't really good. So
like you needed pretty much the MXC to start even the tower to get it done efficiently. And I didn't really bother at the start. It was after New Year when the new Flash events pool was introduced that I even got competitive with the Flash pool. Then I got it pretty quickly and started to progress. Like, I have so many regrets with the first half of the year and so with how I played the game.
Regrets? Why?
Like, I was all over the place with all the, where I focused the XP. Like, 9 plus 2 skills, I didn't have those for the longest of time.
Oh, okay. Yeah, those are the most important skills. At least they used to be. I don't know if they still are.
Yeah.
Yeah, wild cards are really be the way to go.
Yeah, I was tank enough, but not fast enough.
Yeah, when I was still playing, of course, everyone used what's it called?
Lohmann.
Yeah, Lohmann, but also Lusamon. I think the name was Lusamon. Yeah, like. Because he had the one turn dark increase defense, I believe.
Larva. Lusamon Larva.
Yeah, Larvamon, yeah.
Well, that didn't really change the. It was nerfs, but it was still like one of the more important mods for PvP.
Yeah, but I was working towards getting him when I was still playing. But I did it so slowly that I ended up not getting him in time. And yet not at all, because I just kind of
quit. Well, I did cut him, then I pretty much got a better monster that it was obsolete, but when the PvP was reworked, then it became again like the core of the team you had to have it, otherwise you wouldn't survive. Because there was pretty much no way to kill and survive.
Yeah, sure.
Like, it dropped from each mon 200 damage, from 700 to 500.
Yeah, that's a big difference.
Yeah.
Yeah, the...
Like...
What's his face? DGK used him a lot. And then other people started doing it too. But he really basically got a full DM ag pull, like everything in the DM ags that you could ever want, he got for free at some point, because he just kept accumulating DM through PvP using basically larva, and that was it.
There were some other people, like was it Gizgard and maybe some others?
Yeah, and Gutonine as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I knew about it, and I wanted to do it too, but I just didn't. I was lazy.
Well, I came to the forum after some of the podcasts. I was like 4 or 3 months already played the game. And even then I was, to some extent, pretty clueless about some stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. If you don't have other people to talk about, then it's hard to get to know.
I to some extent knew the mechanics, but didn't really care when it didn't felt that competitive.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, at some point I joined the subreddit, which Citrus is the
moderator,
and then he posted about a Discord channel which had a Digimon Heroes part to it. So I joined that, and that there is where I met DGK, Citrus, Gutonine, and a couple other people. And they introduced me to the forum as well. So in the end, I joined the forum. I think I joined the forum after I even started my YouTube channel.
I also did join the Discord channel, but wasn't really active there. From the forums, I read pretty much everything that there was to.
At some point, I even quit being part of the Discord because it was mostly spam, and it wasn't really that interesting. So then we just we talked through the forum mostly. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was. I mean, the forum had a lot of fun to it as well.
Yeah. Like there were a couple of dudes that I was more closer. Like I usually, every post that it was some sort of joke in the base. Or something when I was not really happy with the current situation or something, it was more of the rant. In a more sarcastic way.
Yeah, I actually think the Digimon Heroes team themselves, like Meowmon and Big Bad Designmon, were on the forums. They were a lot of fun, and they were really nice.
Yeah, but like then the like the touch with from the devs to the players, it like vanished at some point. And then there were like they were still around, but not like it felt. For a really long for me that like Bats note some of the information anything like it was not told directly at the people like it was still readable from the game's code but I can't like I'm not it's not available for me I can't do that
and that shouldn't be the way you got your information
like it's the one thing I appreciate the most that you have the information available told to you and mechanics anything then you take use of it like you see best for you that like there were some sales followed by even better sales it was during the last year's Christmas event I think or during the holiday times and then like when it was the anniversary for the game, there was the Yggdrasil event. Like, that was the only time when every single ticket was 5 plus 2.
Oh, wow. That's great. They're actually 5 plus 2 now, too, I believe, but that's just because they, they don't really care anymore.
Yeah, seems that way, and it's the same that I can't really care for it anyway. It was like...
Yeah.
Like the shock was enough in a way. It was really a big addiction. Like I was sacrificing sleep pretty much to play the game. Just to do everything that there was to do.
Let's see. I'm not getting the item I need. It's annoying. I'm trying to get the blue books right now, but to get the
Doesn't the blue book drop from the last boss?
Yeah, it should, but I mean right now I'm not getting it.
Well, the only way you can like increase your chances is to use the green snake with the blow away ability. Can't remember the name. Quetzalmon.
Is there seriously a way to increase the chance of getting it?
Well, kinda, because if you hit the item cap before you get to the boss, you have zero chances to get the... But when you use the blow away skill, it like it doesn't kill the enemy, but it's out of the way, so it can't drop the item.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yes.
Oh, that's so stupid. Yeah, alright. So that, do you know the name of that Digimon? Maybe I have it.
Well, it's either from the free tickets or the green tickets. You should have
Yeah,
if you have.
What is his name?
Quetzal from Gu.
Quetzalmon. Do we. I don't know which one that is.
I type it to the chat, that's what I think it was called.
Yeah. I don't know. Do I have that?
It's a 9-star.
A 9-star?
Yeah.
And it was green or?
Yeah, green.
Quetzal. I don't think I have it actually. No. No, I don't have it. Let's see. The free axe, a 9 green. No, that's not it. So maybe.
I think it was from the GS people.
Okay. Bunch of Lilamon? Metal Cedarmon? Bunch of. No. No. No, it's not there. I don't know, then. Well, okay. Well, I'm just gonna try without then. It should drop at some point. I mean, I got the yellow and the black ones pretty quickly as well, so.
Well, it's not in the GSP. See the free tickets.
Yeah, I already checked those too, but it's not in there. Let's see. I will. I'll just have to do it a slow way then. Which is fine. I keep misclicking. It's annoying. But yeah, I'm playing on an emulator right now. I'd rather be playing on my phone. Works better on it, honestly.
Yeah, I did also for the longest of time when I was actually unemployed for 8 or so months. I played on an emulator, just sitting on the computer all day.
Okay.
And when during the Christmas time, when I actually my tablet's battery burned out, so it didn't charge correctly, and then to get the spare part, it took so long to get the part from the.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, but I didn't really mind. Except, like, I still had the bill to pay.
Yeah.
That was the only bad part.
Do you know what the drop cap is? Like, how many out?
It's
many
usually 10. It's usually 10.
10. Because I think I keep hitting 10 before I get to the boss. I mean, I currently have 8. And I'm at the round before the boss. So I think if they drop 3 things or 2 things, then I'm at the max. Okay, they didn't.
Well, if it's more than 10, it's 10 or 15. Like the mono events were always 15, the hard ones, and some of the top right events were really frustrating with the bad drop caps. Like, you got more of the X than the items that you needed.
Yeah, I remember that. That was annoying.
Yeah. Like, they kept, to some extent, increasing the caps that you needed to some events.
Huh.
Like, really cheap way to increase the increase the playtime for the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I bet they did that on purpose.
Yes. Too much.
Let's see. Okay, this is gonna be a finishing blow, I think. Now let's see.
And you should, from the screen, you should have the chance at least to get the item.
Yeah, I did get it.
Okay.
It's so now.
Like I had the same problem when I was farming for the red books.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that was annoying too. I think I have two now, right? Two. No, three. Okay, so I need two more. Yeah, I'm just gonna do the 61, then I'll use an extra battery, but whatever. Yeah. I really wanna finish this dude. He's cool. Oh man, I forgot his name again. I'm so bad with speaking and remembering names. What was it? P4lm3 or something? No. I don't know. But yeah, he's cool, so I wanna get him. And then I think I'm just gonna do an act pull. And after that I think I'm gonna quit the stream because it's been 1.5 hours now.
Okay.
So I don't know how long it will take to actually get him. Because I still need 2 blue books and then 4 green books. So that might actually still take a while. Yeah, well, we'll see. Let's see. What was his skill? Inflicts 1/1 damage, changes all cards to wild. Okay. Don't use this. Hey, Paul, it was fun talking to you, but I'm gonna get out of the voice chat right now.
Okay.
And just focus on playing the game a bit to try and get to finish this thing. So yeah, it was fun talking to you, and thanks for joining me.
It was my pleasure. See ya.
See ya.